Dear parents, has the document popped up on your screen?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Am I audible to everyone? Can you see the document?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's start. When we talk about NEP 2020, is the continuation of actually the two previous education policies. The first education policy came in 1968 and the second came in 1986. The second education policy was revised further in 1992 and our policy having almost 66 pages was prepared. As we all know that every institute has its own vision and mission also. One is in the broad spectrum, in the second is short term.
Sorry to interrupt you, ma'am.
Sure. Yes.
Ma'am, are you in same document which is visible in on our screen?
Yes, it's the same document.
But it is different here in our, on our screen.
I am just giving the introduction, ma'am.
मैम हमें नहीं शो हो रहे डॉक्यूमेंट्स आपके.
हाँ जी, आपको डॉक्यूमेंट नजर आ रहा है मेरे वाला?
यस
यस मैम.
मैम बट इट इज नॉट द सेम यू आर रीडिंग.
आई एम नॉट एट ऑल रीडिंग द डॉक्यूमेंट.
ओके ओके देन इट्स ओके मैम.
आई एम नॉट रीडिंग द डॉक्यूमेंट, आई एम जस्ट गिविंग इंट्रोडक्शन.
ओके ओके फाइन मैम, आई वाज जस्ट कंफर्मिंग मैम.
Okay, they will learn together in this foundational stage. The second stage will be a preparatory stage. There is a gradual transition from activity-based learning to classroom learning. It includes our classes 3, 4, and 5. Here emphasis will be on four language skills. बच्चा जो लैंग्वेज सीखता है उसी के फोर जो हैं स्किल्स उनके ऊपर फोकस्ड रहेगा. The four language skills are reading, writing, speaking and listening. And these four skills are further categorized into two. The first one is receptive and the second is productive. From these four skills, the two skills which are learning and reading, they are receptive skills. And writing and speaking as productive skills. Then we move to the middle stage. Here, subject-oriented pedagogical and curricular methodology will be adopted. Subject teachers for learning discussion of more abstract concepts in each subject across sciences, mathematics, arts, social sciences, and humanity. We can call it as a stage from ambiguity to clarity. Means unke jo concepts hain वो और अच्छे से क्लियर हो जाएंगे व्हेन दे विल रीच दिस मिडिल स्टेज. द फोर्थ स्टेज इज अवर हाई स्कूल स्टेज. इट विल बी फोर इयर्स ऑफ मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी स्टडी, ग्रेटर डेप्थ, ग्रेटर क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग, ग्रेटर अटेंशन एंड लाइफ एस्पिरेशंस. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस high school stage is greater flexibility and students' choice. Here the students will have choice to choose the subject. They will be given exposure to more subjects and they will be getting more flexibility. और यहाँ पर पहुँचते पहुँचते उनके assessment modules भी क्या होंगे? Assessments थोड़ा कंपैरेटिवली जल्दी होंगी लाइक इन कंपैरिजन टू प्रीवियस स्टेजेस. एंड असेसमेंट्स हमेशा एक जैसी नहीं रहेंगी और वो बहुत फ्रीक्वेंटली होंगी. व्हाट हैपेंड अर्लियर, लाइक ऐसा कभी भी नहीं हुआ था कि जो बच्चे की अर्ली चाइल्डहुड एंड केयर एंड एजुकेशन वॉज ऑलवेज इग्नोर्ड इन द प्रीवियस एजुकेशन पॉलिसीज. In the previous education policies, what happened? More focus was laid on classes 1 to 10. Early childhood was actually formally ignored. NEP 2020 has brought a drastic change in our outlook towards ECCE. हमें कुछ major changes यहाँ मिलेंगे ताकि बच्चे की जो शुरुआती दौर है लर्निंग का उसमें कुछ ऐसा सिखाया जाए कि वो पूरी जिंदगी दे विल कैरी अलोंग. एंड फर्स्ट थ्री इयर्स वी ऑल नो आर वेरी क्रूशियल इयर्स ऑफ अवर लाइफ. हियर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अ प्रेपरेटरी क्लासेस बिफोर क्लास वन. प्लीज पुट योर डिवाइस ऑन म्यूट. For children of age 0 to 5 years, learning shall be based on play-based learning with focus of developing. वो खेलते खेलते ही सीखेंगे in these 5 years. Reading with comprehension. First of all, they will comprehend कि actually चीज क्या है. Then they will write. Then basic mathematical operations की कैसे calculations हो रही हैं, क्यों additions हो रही हैं, how to calculate, how to subtract. Then they will come to basic life skills. Another important aspect of NEP is to curtail the dropout rates. What happens? For certain reasons, the children may drop their schooling. They may not continue their classes. कुछ कारण ऐसे होते हैं कि बच्चे normally क्या करते हैं? They leave the schools. Sometimes teacher are aware कि for so and so reason इस बच्चे ने ये school छोड़ा है. Sometimes we don't know. They leave the schools without informing anyone, without sharing their concern even. So some contemporary subjects, these include artificial intelligence, holistic health, data science, organic living, design thinking and machine learning. This artificial intelligence CBSE has already introduced some 2 years back. CBSE ne pehle hi introduce kar diya hai in the coming years, and these they are going to introduce these contemporary subjects. Then we have year-long course during grade 6 to 8. This module is specially for grade 6 to 8. 6 to 8 age group class, us age group mein jo bachche aate hain, this is designed for those. Survey and hands-on experience of a sampling of important vocational crafts such as carpentry, electric work, metal work, gardening, pottery making, etc. Vocational subjects are प्रैक्टिकल एंड फर्स्ट हैंड स्किल्स कि बच्चे को इन चीज़ों की हमेशा जिंदगी में ज़रूरत पड़ेगी एंड इन चीज़ों के लिए उनको एक्सपोजर मिलेगा इन देयर स्कूल ओनली फ्रॉम ग्रेड 6 to 8. वी हैव सीन दैट स्टूडेंट्स उनको थोड़ी सी भी किसी भी काम के लिए ज़रूरत है दे विल कॉल देयर पेरेंट्स टू हेल्प देम आउट एंड इफ दे आर इन द स्कूल दे विल कॉल देयर टीचर्स. So here they would be given hands-on practice. Unko choti-choti cheezein sikhai jayengi. And this will be decided by the state and local communities. Ki unki local jo area hai, us community ki kya zarurat hai. Depending on that, they will be given hands-on to vocation. One major decision has been taken, that is 10-day bagless period during grade 6 to 8 for students to intern with local vocational experts such as carpenters, gardeners, potters, artists, etc. अब स्कूल क्या अरेंज करेगा? दिस इज फॉर ग्रेड 6 टू 8 ओनली, कि पूरे साल में उनको 10 दिन ऐसे मिलेंगे व्हेन दे डोंट हैव टू कैरी देयर बैग्स टू द स्कूल. चिल्ड्रन वुड बी गोइंग टू द स्कूल बट दे विल नॉट कैरी देयर बैग्स, मींस वो बैग्स के बिना जाएंगे. दे विल स्पेंड अ डे इन द स्कूल विदाउट देयर बैग्स. Internship opportunities to learn vocational subjects throughout grade 6 to 12. Then 6 to 12 के लिए vocational subjects होंगे, skill based learning होगी उनकी. वहां किसी vocation को सीखेंगे वो, carpentry, gardening and many more. Then they will be given exposure to vocational courses through online mode also. Periodic exposure to activities outside school through like meeting local artists and craftsmen. They will be given a chance to meet local artists and craftsmen also. School arrange करता रहेगा ये अपने बच्चों के लिए, कभी artist को बुला लिया, कभी sometimes they can be potter also to the school, ताकि बच्चों के साथ उनकी interaction हो. They will learn more about. And these experts would be giving demonstrations to the students in the school. Then we have vocational courses to be offered through open and distance learning mode again. By 2025, at least 50% of learners shall have exposure to vocational education. It's a great step towards vocational education. कि बाय 2025 वो 50% लर्नर्स को दिस वोकेशनल एजुकेशन का एक्सपोजर दिया जाएगा. अगेन अ हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू पेरेंट्स, देयर इज अ डिस्टरबेंस एट द बैक, प्लीज पुट योर डिवाइस ऑन म्यूट. Then emphasis will be given on health education as well. Health plays an important role in everyone's life and the well-being of ours. Basic training in health, including preventive health, mental health and well-being, nutrition, personal and public hygiene and first aid, detrimental and damaging effects of alcohol, tobacco and other drugs. This is the need of the hour. We need to tell students that health plays an important role in our lives. We all know, हम बच्चों को कहते रहते हैं this is to be done, this is to be done, कि तुम्हें ये करना है, ये करना है. Sometimes we forget, हम ये बोल देते हैं ये करना है, we forget ये क्यों करना है. This will also be taught to the students. कि we say alcohol is not to be consumed. Say no to tobacco. Say no to other drugs. Why are we saying no? This will be taught to the students in the school. और ये तभी सीख पाएंगे जब उनके पास क्या होगी? Mental health. उनके पास thinking होगी. Why? Teachers are saying, why parents are saying. Okay, now we have talked about many things that this will be taught, that will be taught. हमने बच्चों को ये सिखाना है, हमने बच्चों को वो सिखाना है. Now we It's a time of assessment. We need to assess कि हम जो बच्चे को सिखा रहे हैं, whether they have learnt, how much they have learnt, in which ways they have learnt. We need to know that ke bachcho ke learning paths bhi kya hain. Suppose whatever was taught, humne kuch share kiya, bachche ko kuch sikhaya, kahi hands on practice karwai, kahi unko vocation ke liye exposure mila, kya bachche ne usme se kuch sikha bhi hai, whether they have learnt? Aur jo bachcho ne sikha hai, is there any scope? and the result of the school examination to be used only for development purposes of the school education, not for any other purposes. कि school education को कैसे further develop किया जा सकता है for public disclosure by schools of their overall students outcomes, that this is what our students have learned, these are the outcomes, ये हमारे बच्चों ने सीखा है. And for continuous monitoring and improvement of schooling system, obviously when we assess the students we get to know ki okay mere bacche ne ye sikha hai, agar kuch nahi sikha hum use kaise sikha sakte hain, there is a scope for us also as teachers. This is going to provide an insight to teachers also after assessing the students. Then NEP has some guidelines for assessments also. Guidelines will be prepared by NCERT in consultation with major stakeholders such as boards of assessment, National Assessment Center for School Education, etc. Transformation in the assessment system by 2022-23 academic session. So we will have different assessment system to align with the National Curriculum Framework for School Education 2021. Abhi students will be having in the next year different assessment system. We will keep in updating you as and when we get an updation from CBSE NCERT. The same will be shared with you also time to time. Then we have National Assessment Center for School Education System. This center will advise the school boards regarding new assessment patterns and latest researches. जो भी कोई assessment patterns होंगे वो हमेशा जो आएंगे हमारे पास दो will be based on latest researches, जो आजकल research हो रही है, that this assessment can be done in this way, in a better way. This is a better way to conduct the assessment. For promoting collaborations between school boards, to become an instrument for sharing of best practices between school boards, about shifting their assessment patterns towards meeting the skill requirements of the 21st century and in consonance with the state's stated objectives of this policy. So this will be done by National Assessment Center for School Education to bringing about the new assessment systems. And NEP has taken a major step that teachers who are going to teach these young children in the school, they will be provided proper education. They have designed these courses for the teachers. First is 4-year integrated B.Ed, then 2-year B.Ed, and then 1-year B.Ed. All B.Ed programs will include training in time-tested techniques in pedagogy, multi-level teaching and evaluation, teaching children with disabilities, teaching children with special interests or talents, use of educational technology, and learner-centered and collaborative learning. So you will have well-equipped teachers in the schools also. Trained teachers, then teachers and teacher education policy. This is for teachers only. It then NEP talks about continuous professional development and improving standards, how teaching standards can be improved. Teachers will undertake 50 hours of continuous professional development every year, driven by their own interests. So हर एक टीचर को 50 आवर्स की जो कंपल्सरी टीचर ट्रेनिंग लेनी ही होगी टू इक्विप देमसेल्व्स विद द लेटेस्ट असेसमेंट एंड व्हाटएवर न्यू कम्स इन द field of education through their workshops and trainings also. And teachers will go for training sessions in online mode also. These are certain like how to ensure equitable and inclusive education. This is for teachers. So then they have mentioned efficient resourcing and effective governance through school complexes and clusters. They have उन्होंने कुछ ऐसे मॉड्यूल्स दिए हैं फॉर द स्कूल्स टू इंश्योर कि बच्चे एक्चुअल में लर्न कर रहे हैं. दे आर नॉट ओनली लाइक क्रैमिंग, वो क्रैमिंग नहीं कर रहे. दे हैव इंक्लूडेड मैनी सब्जेक्ट्स, जैसे उनको आर्ट, म्यूजिक, साइंस, ये सब कोलेबोरेट किए हैं हियर. दीज आर फॉर स्कूल्स, दीज आर द गाइडलाइंस फॉर स्कूल्स. सम इनिशिएटिव्स हैव बीन टेकन for school education. NEP 2020 on standard setting and accreditation. A self-regulation or accreditation system will be instituted for all stages, private, public and philanthropic, to ensure compliance with essential quality standards. A minimal set of standard based on basic parameters named safety, security, infrastructure, number of teachers, financial probability and sound processes of governance, which shall be followed by the school. ये जो parameters दिए हैं schools के लिए, these have been given for the betterment of the students. कि बच्चे को कहीं भी ऐसा ना लगे at any point that he or she is not taken care of well in the school. Then state UTs will set up independent statewide body called State School Standard Authority. So they have given few leverages to the state boards also, that this can be further done for the betterment of the education. Then they have given some key features of SQAA for CBSE schools. Self-assessment tools for schools. Schools will also assess themselves to review their performance against predefined indicators, benchmarks. And schools will focus on enhancement of quality, recognition of excellence, promotion of accountability, and benchmark schools across a range of descriptors or indicators of assessment. Then we have CBSE has developed a comprehensive framework termed as School Quality Assessment and Assurance. The disclosure will be at the school level based on proficiency of school. Technical documents, standards has been prepared. E-portal for school is being prepared, piloted in the year 2021-22 and finally rolled out in the year 2022-23. Now they have given how transforming assessments and examination, ke kaise inko transform kiya jaye. They will not take up all the schools. A key statement, assessment in classes 3, 5 and 8 pilot in selected schools will be conducted in 2021-22. Holistic report cards for CBSE schools is being prepared. They have prepared a manual on assessments for and of learning is being prepared, which they are going to hand over to each schools for the purpose of assessments. Then they will provide trainings for paper setters and moderators is going on to standardize question papers. 10% higher order application oriented source case based questions till it becomes 60%. Now let us come to this e-portal. Work initiated on the development of question based for competency based items HOTS for class 6 to 10 in major subjects will be available at Diksha. डियर पेरेंट्स दीज hots questions and many other questions e content is available. You can download this app and access the resources. You will find ample resources for each and every subject, and we keep updating the questions on weekly basis. You can access it anytime, anywhere, and on any device. Then again, we have discussed that they are going to provide quality education. For that, they need to train the teachers. They have taken certain initiatives. कि teachers को further कहाँ पर किस चीज की जरूरत है? Then there are certain curricular initiatives like arts and sports integrated education. Principals as pedagogical leaders and preparation of annual pedagogical plans that throughout the year के बच्चा कैसी plan के साथ क्या चीज सीखेगा. Then implementation of experiential learning pedagogies like arts and sports integrated storytelling, gaming, mathematics and Hindi at two levels. English and Sanskrit will also be introduced at two levels from the session 21-22. But because of this present COVID-19, this did not happen. They are going to introduce this in the next year, next session. Introduction of 9 vocational courses of 12-hour duration in class 6 to 8 in 2020. Then, for ensuring competency-based education in school, what they have done? Mandatory adoption of learning outcomes by CBSE schools, creative and critical thinking, practice tests, informal assessments through student enrichment activities. Like these days also, we give some enrichment activities. बच्चे को पता भी नहीं चलता कि मैम ने मुझे assess कर लिया. This is what I have learned. When they do, we get to know that this is what a child has learned. And introduction of case-based questions in question paper design. Then we have mandatory online training on experiential learning and competency-based education. Development of resource material handbook on experiential learning teachers resources for achieving LO's term. There are some enrichment activities like students ke liye kuch competitive exams they keep organizing. These include Aryabhatta Giant Challenge, then we have Heritage India Quiz, Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat, CBSE Science Challenge, then science exhibitions, Khelo India. We have expression series recently, like in our schools, many of the students participated in this. They came up with beautiful projects. Then reading challenges. There are certain expectations from the school also, and all the schools will ensure कि हम जो हमारे से जो एक्सपेक्ट किया जा रहा है वी आर गोइंग टू डिलीवर दैट. देन दे हैव गिवन एंश्योर कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग एट ऑल लेवल्स. दिस इज फॉर स्कूल्स. एंगेज विद पेरेंट्स एंड कम्युनिटी फॉर अ पॉजिटिव लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट. एंड नॉर्मली इट इज सर हम लोग वी ऑल नो कि बच्चा तभी ज्यादा सीखता है व्हेन पेरेंट्स आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इनटू द टीचिंग एंड लर्निंग प्रोसेस. जितनी आपकी इन्वॉल्वमेंट ज्यादा होगी उतनी बच्चे की आउटपुट हमेशा ज्यादा रहेगी. सो हियर देयर आर सम पॉइंट्स व्हिच स्कूल्स नीड टू टेक केयर. एंड पेरेंट्स से हम सिर्फ यही एक्सपेक्ट करेंगे कि बच्चे